What do you get when you mix Mentos, Diet Coke, a skateboard, 150 teachers in Oklahoma City, and an area that's riddled by tornadoes? I don't know, but we did it anyway. I'm Steve Spangler, and I'm all about making science fun. For the last 20 years, I've been teaching ways to turn ordinary science experiments into unforgettable learning experiences. I have an amazing team who will do whatever it takes to affect the way people think about science. And to do that, I live by one motto: make it big, do it right, give it class. Well, if you've never seen the Mentos and Diet Coke reaction, where have you been living all this time? It's okay, I'll give you a 20-second crash course. Go. Soda by its very nature is packed with carbon dioxide and it wants to come out when you open up the cap. In fact, anything you drop inside will help that carbonation come out. Mentos have tiny little pits or craters on the outside. They're called nucleation points. It's the perfect place for carbon dioxide bubbles to gather. Because they're so heavy, when you turn it over and drop it down inside, they fall to the bottom, the carbon dioxide is released, and you get the perfect geyser. See, it's perfect. We have to thank Lee Merrick, a chemistry teacher, not only a great chemistry teacher from Naperville, Illinois, who shared at a conference that if you happen to use Mentos, it was a nice substitute for the lifesavers. And so that's it. That's how the Mentos started. I can tell you that nobody really cared for a long, long time. It wasn't until September of 2005, the lovely Kim Christensen was in the backyard at KUSA 9 News when she happened to get a little soaked. Because she didn't move out of the way. Watch this. 3, 2, 1, pull. Good. Ah!
Woo!
Tell me that that's not awesome.
I did get
that,
it. That's awesome.
No, that's so sorry.
That's okay.
Look at you. You are.
It tastes kind of good.
Wasn't that fun?
Yeah, it was fun.
That's the best I have ever seen. Although this little test tube called a baby soda bottle was a great dropping device for it, this created the problem, and that was not everybody could drop them equally. And when a producer from Discovery Channel called that happened to work on a little show called Mythbusters, they said, we had seen your thing with Kim Christensen and saw that it went up 18 feet. How do you make it go higher? Well, there are a whole bunch of different ways to look at it, but that prompted me to start thinking about a dropper device that would allow everybody to drop equally. This was a device my wife had purchased. It was almost like PVC, but it made this hamper for the dirty clothes. And as I looked at that pipe, I thought, that's probably about the size of the opening of a 2-liter bottle. Well, lo and behold, it was. It fit perfectly. Now there was just a way to be able to attach it. So this is where the 2-liter cap came in, a regular 2-liter cap, and this went down inside like this. And so now we had a way to be able to secure this in place, which was perfect. So this could go on here like this. And this was the first dropper device for the Mentos Geyser reaction. More pressure. That's what I wanted. I wanted it to go higher. It should go 35 or 40 feet in the air. It just needed to build up more pressure. And that's where this little device saved the day. It's basically the same idea. It's just that there's no holes on the side because there's a new little dropping mechanism. And you only have to use 3 or 4 Mentos to get almost 35 feet in height as the geyser blasts off. This screws onto the top, and now your geyser is ready to go. But it's even better because watch this. I can actually take the Mentos after the reaction has taken place and now collect them back in the geyser tube, seal it up, twist it off. Even though they're wet, the nucleation points are still perfect. This twists onto a new bottle and I get another reaction using the same Mentos. The next issue isn't a design issue, it's really an experimental issue, and that is thousands upon thousands of you have done this reaction. How high does the geyser go? It seems to be that's the bragging point. Well, little did I know that I could solve that problem simply by taking this whole thing and turning it 90 degrees. In comes the skateboard, because all I have to do now is to take the bottle and attach it to the skateboard. That's where we need duct tape. See, I had my kids. I just put them on the skateboard and make them hold the Diet Coke. Drop the Mentos in and then the Diet Coke, the kids and the Mentos. But then my wife said that's not a good idea. That's where this solution was perfect. All right, we got a flat surface, we got a skateboard, Mentos, this is how it works. Ready? You pull like this and you drop it, and it goes! It goes really far! Usually right up into some lady's driveway. Higginsworth, can you go get that, please? Keep that light on me, please. Thank you. Well, while this is fun, it's not the easiest way to do it. And it's not the least expensive way to do it. That's why we had to come up with a new solution. It's this. So we teamed up with our friends at Science Museum Oklahoma and turned 150 teachers loose, all with Geyser cars, to create an unforgettable learning experience. Take a look at this.